there are a number of sort of wasted spaces in most houses, especially under the stairs. Since my wife and daughter have an extensive collection of shoes, I decided making an understairs shelf for them to hide at least some of their shoes. This is how the stairs looked before, and this is how they are going to look by the end of the second part of this video. First, I removed the drywall. I also had to remove one stud, but I think this is okay, as the main purpose of this stud was just to hold the drywall. The stairs themselves are solidly built and should be fine without it. Next, I need making an enclosure to form a compartment where the shelf will locate. I used the 3/4 birch plywood left over from other projects. I didn't want using a new plywood sheet for the enclosure that will be hidden from view, and decided to rather join the smaller leftover pieces using wood cookies. For one small side, I used solid birch. I like crack sprocket screws. As you can see, I used a lot of them for this project. I used this paint for the enclosure.
Okay, the boring part is skipped, so now I have the base side and another side. They all painted, and I'm going to try some preliminary assembly. So this is one side. By mistake I drill open both sides, but I'm gonna use the drills on this side because this side will not be accessible when this is under this staircase. So this is the other side. I'm gonna do it like this, and this stop to assembly. And I also have a cover, so it's gonna be covered like that. So, and this is the compartment that's going to be under the staircase, and there'll be a movable platform going this way. Okay, let's start to assemble, preliminary assembly, and see what. They fixed the walls temporarily just to see how it fits together. So, and that's how it looks. And I also installed the rails, which is going to be used for the moving platform, just so to see how it works.
Now it is time to start making the movable shelf itself. I used pre-finished plywood I bought in a local home improvement store. The outer veneers of the plywood are beautiful, but the inner ones were inconsistent and with gaps, so I was a little bit disappointed with the material choice. However, from aesthetic point of view, it looks gorgeous. To cover the plywood edges, I decided to cut 1/4 to 3/4 inch birch strips and glue them to all visible plywood edges. And I did some edge trimming.